and tarnation, y'all expect me to give you now? I done give you my best bananas. I ain't got nothing left. I give and give and ain't ever enough for you city folk. Save me from a fixin', you think you own me. Well, let me tell you something. I ain't never been nobody's slave, and I ain't fixin' to start now. So just enjoy the bananas and leave me be.
I just wanted to say thanks for the bananas. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to give you that impression. Hi, I'm Duke of the Bump. Welcome to Let's Play Popful Mail, episode number 6. Or, I'm sorry, Let's Play Popful Mail Redux. I have to throw that in there just so you know that, that this isn't the original Let's Play Popful Mail. Because I've gotten quite a few hits on my original video since I started doing the Redux series. I guess some of you want to go back and watch the old videos to compare and contrast. Which I can't blame you. Things have gotten a lot better since then. We're in a golden era of LPing now. So, we just defeated Boney Rebler, whose name might be a reference to Barney Rubble, as one of the commenters said. I forget who said it, sorry. Which, if that's the case, that's a pretty bizarre reference to make, since the boss pretty much had nothing to do with Barney Rubble. I mean, there were no skeletons or horses in the Flintstones, so I don't know. You might notice some of the numeric values for the time in the save slots, and possibly my money. You might notice that they're different than they were in the previous video. I had a little mishap with my save file. I accidentally overwrote my main save file with my practice save file, so I lost a bunch of footage. So I had to basically start the game over and get back to where I was. Which didn't take too long, since I could, you know, frame skip my way through all the cutscenes, and by that point I was pretty well versed in the first few chapters of this game, since I played through them a few times recently. I'm getting a little bit of stuttering in the emulator. I hope it's not showing up in the video. It's not affecting the gameplay. It just looks a little off. Kind of a screen tearing thing. Not sure why. I was messing with my bitrate settings to see if I could get a little higher quality, but I ended up going back to what I started with, so I'm not sure. Maybe I changed something by mistake. But the save file shouldn't be a problem in the future. I misunderstood the way the simulator handles the save files, and well, it's complicated and not very interesting, but needless to say, it should not happen again. So sorry to break the illusion for those of you who are overly concerned about that sort of thing. So after we defeated Boney Rebler, we got the key that will unlock the door to the hot springs area. I think I said in a previous video that it's not really a hot springs, and I guess it is. It just doesn't look much like a hot springs. It just looks kind of like a generic cave. I mean, when you think hot springs, you think like steam, or I mean, maybe not lava, but like red rocks, maybe, to kind of give you the impression of heat. But this area just looks kind of like a dank, cool cave, so I'm not sure where they get hot springs from. Might be a mistranslation. I don't know. They take a lot of liberties with the translation in this game. Like, what the game calls badgers, I'm pretty sure are supposed to actually be tanukis. The Japanese raccoon dog, famous for large assets and being a character a suit, rather, in Super Mario Bros. 3. Which, you would think that, I mean, Americans know what tanukis are, thanks to SMB3. You wouldn't think they would need to change it, but, I don't know. I'm not sure if they even look like badgers. I'm not totally sure what badgers look like. Then again, maybe they're not supposed to be tanukis. Maybe I'm casting aspersions on the intent of the designers based on their national heritage, which is a pretty close-minded thing of me to do. I hate this screen. Okay, we should be good. There's a healing area coming up here pretty soon. See, that's another thing. Usually when you think hot springs in a video game, it's somewhere you can go to rest and recuperate. But this game doesn't really, or the hot springs in this game don't really do that. They're just kind of, see what I mean? Look at the background. It just looks like just another kind of cave. So, I don't know. But this is Monster Mart. It's kind of a mini town. Not really a full-fledged town. They're just a weapon shop and... Damn it, get the heck up there. Just a weapon shop and a dude to talk to. So we'll go on ahead and check this out. I don't think there's any better equipment here or anything. Nope, same stuff I already have. So let's heal up. I don't have any bullion or anything to sell, do I? Oh yeah, I do. I have two of them. Nice. We have plenty of money. Should be able to buy all of the next equipment we need. All of the sudden? A weird elf kit. Oh, great. That guy.
Hey, kid. Ask me anything. I am totally in the know.
Say, AMA. Have you heard anything about a magician named Muttonhead? He used to be my teacher.
Yo, blowout fuck, Muttonhead? Ah, that bum. He can hardly cast a decent spell these days. In fact, some of the villagers say he's the rat that revived Garadus. But, we got to capture that arrogant jerk.
You've captured my teacher? Oh, this news is too good for words. If I might ask, where is he being held?
Why would you want to see him? He's loony. Insane. Oh well, no matter. None of God's business. He's held at the top of these caves.
Boy, this game is just a cultural smorgasbord of interesting accents. I don't know what that was supposed to be. New Yorker? Sort of a Boston accent? Kind of a New England-y thing? But the accent wasn't very consistent, so it's hard to tell. So, who's been watching the E3 stuff? That's going on. In fact, it's going on as I record this video. There's been some interesting stuff. I'm not really a big console person. I don't know why I bothered killing that bat. I'm not going to go get that money. Oh god. I'm borrowing a 360 that I haven't really used that much. And I used to have a 360, but I sold it to get funds for when I moved into this apartment to pay for the deposit and all that. And don't get me wrong, there are a bunch of good 360 games that I played. Deadly Premonition, Bayonetta, Mega Man 9, which is also on PSN. Actually, those are all also on PlayStation. But the point is, they're not available on PC. So, you know, consoles have their place. Explosion Man, great game. Play that several years ago. Shadow Complex, fuck Orson Scott Card, but... the game was a great game. I know there's a lot of controversy surrounding it because of Orson Scott Card was theoretically profiting off of that game. But, you know, there are a lot of, is there anything? This might not be the right way. I want to save just in case. But yeah, I mean, if you feel strongly about supporting Orson Scott Card, a lot of people like donating to a charity to offset the money that he gets. Oh, okay, yeah, this is right. Hold on.
Oh my, who in the world are you?
Oh, look here. It's a Martin Hayes, a little pet.
You know my teacher?
Sure! And you're gonna tell me, where is that windbag, eh?
Wait, you don't understand. I was looking for...
Shut up! You are his pupil! You know... I'm not gonna beat you, silly. You're not gonna like me so much now, eh?
I warn you, sir. I'm very good with this staff.
Oh, I bet you are. Okay. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to leave and then come back into this room. Most of the bosses don't have a cutscene like that before you start fighting them. It's just kind of a pop-up text window and the battle just starts. So I'm going to go ahead and save now that I left and came back. I've had the volume up too high. Sorry about that. So just in case I do die, I don't have to sit through the dialogue again. Just this, what kind of a freaky little pest are you? Jeez! That's my Italian accent. Which might be almost as high quality as my Midwestern American accent. But yeah, Shadow Complex. Donate to charity if you don't like supporting Orson Scott Card. Point is, lots of great console games. I'm just, yeah, okay. I like how open the PC is. I mean, yeah, you can argue that Steam is doing a lot of the same things that the consoles are doing DRM-wise. And, that's a totally valid argument. But the point is, you don't have to use Steam on the PC. There are a lot of other options, available to you. So, I like PCs for that. I like PCs because, if something in it, if a part dies, you don't have to replace the whole computer. Like, you would have to replace a whole console or send it back for repairs. You can just replace whatever part, died on you. Which I've had to do with my current computer. I've replaced the, video card and the power supply in them. And, it's going okay now. Cross my fingers, knock on wood, throw salt over my shoulder. Is that a thing? I know if you spill salt. I thought I had him because it says zero, but I guess I just blew up one of his dolls. But yeah, I have to admit, the PS4 looks pretty interesting. All the built-in sharing stuff, the ability to stream games from it natively without any additional hardware would be pretty cool. Oh no! Oh man, this is going to be just like that time, well, I don't know, maybe not. I'm at zero hit points. Oh, excellent. That was a close one. Alright, cutscene coming up.
Hey, you're a fan in my neck, eh?
Oh my, he certainly is a chatty pest. Well, let him babble away. I'll just take his body along for the bounty.
Don't think so much, Boomba Hunter. My head is worth nothing, and my body, she's out of here.
Boomba?
Ah, well, I thought it was too good to be true.
Let's double check and make sure it didn't use one of my elixirs when I hit zero hit points. I should have three. Yeah, okay, awesome. I went back for an elixir that I missed in the Elf Village area. So yeah, hear more about my opinions about the new consoles and E3 and Orson Scott Card in the next Let's Play Popful Mail Redux video. I'm Duke the Bump, and I will see you later.